testimony given to the city of the truth, all truth?
Nothing but.
Would you please state your full name and spell it and give your home residential address?
My name is Ron Kordish, K-O-R-D-I-S-H. I reside at 102 Constitution Avenue, Jessup. I own another property at 250 Morgan Street.
Would you please state why you oppose the proposal of the applicant that the Borough Council find that certain provisions of the zoning ordinance are exclusionary for its construction of this plant in the M2 heavy industrial zone, and that the remedy should be that this plant should be allowed as a conditional use in the M1 zone on the hill?
Well, my objections are many. First of all, this company, Invenergy, they knew our zoning regulations for years. They knew this when they came in. They decided that they could get by these regulations somehow. They knew the amount of land that was available to them. They knew it was a tax-free zone. Were they invited? Who invited them and when? What did they think? They could buy the zoning officers, council, townspeople with their pasta, pastries, pizza, t-shirts, tacos. I could run this right through. I could see right through this smog. Can you? Speaking of smog, my second objection is the pollution that they will create. Air, noise, visual, water. They say it's perfectly safe. Really? I don't believe them. In our neighboring community of Archibald, we have a 67 megawatt cogen plant. All over the internet, there are pictures of the plume that this plant creates. The plume is smog, greenhouse gases. Can you imagine what a 1,500 megawatt plant would look like? In number two pencil or whatever color you want to put it in, it's enormous. This plant will create 22.4 times that amount, according to my calculations. How will this affect our citizens and our children that have asthma or COPD? This is your decision, Council. It's very important. If you don't take my word for it, ask any doctor, any nurse. They'll expand on it. It will be noisy. The Casey Highway at 90 decibels will not buffer a 70 decibel rattle trap. As far as I can tell, 90 decibels and 70 decibels is 160 decibels. Simple math, more noise. What will this do to our water? What chemicals are in the discharge of water? We asked that question multiple times. Your experts could not or would not answer. Why? Are they experts or puppets on the payroll? This plant will be visually grotesque, hideous, repulsive to some. What business would want to come to Jessup and set up shop next door to this monstrosity? What family would be attracted to build in our fine community with this gas plant lurking above them? One of Invenergy's many television commercials features a former mayor of Bethlehem. He claims property values went up. He claims the same thing will happen to Jessup. Do we want to look like Bethlehem? Who here believes property values will increase because of this? Nobody I know. I'm opposed to this company also because of the way they conduct their business. They do not offer a specific set of plans, but any resident wanting to build must have an approved set of plans and must abide by our zoning laws. Why should they be any different? A solid, unwavering set of plans. After all, this will affect not only Jessup, but the entire Northeast corridor of Pennsylvania. It seems to me they think they can spread a bunch of money around and propaganda and get what they want out of us. Oh, speaking of money, in my estimation, conservatively, Invenergy stands to make at least $350 million per year from this plant. They offer us $500,000 to be divvied up between the borough, the school district, and the county. They also promise $30 million in consumer business to local bars and restaurants and watering holes. May I remind you that they also plan a convenient food market, a gas station, and a hotel near the site, as well as a childcare facility. Will those workers that have 30 minutes for lunch come down into town to eat lunch? I don't think so. Will those same workers go home Friday night, shower, and come back to Jessup and dine in one of our wonderful eateries? I don't think so. Can Invenergy guarantee 50% of their workforce will be from Jessup? Can they guarantee 25%? Could they guarantee 10%? I don't think so. $500,000, gentlemen, is insulting. Compare this dollar amount to the money that you can get in store. By my estimation, which is conservative, you gave Canyon Falls $1 million up front for a 3.67 megawatt plant that operates 2% of the time. The school district negotiated $200,000 per year and another $85,250 per year. The city of Cannon Falls is getting $449,500 per year. The school district is getting $85,250 per year to do with what they will. And this is a 20-year guaranteed agreement that goes up $25,000 a year for the next 6 years, and then 2% after that. So once again, $500,000 is insulting. And that was by an article by Ken Haggerty. You are not being truthful and forthcoming with this. This is not jobs for Jessup. It's jobs in Jessup for transients. These workers do not live here. Very few of them do. I am personally appalled by their arrogance, telling us, the citizenry of Jessup, what we should do. Let me ask, of those 600 temporary jobs, will 50%, 25%, 10% even be from Jessup? Will all of those workers be subjected to background checks? Invenergy runs ads in our local newspapers. They claim they'll have cleaner air because we will be supporting a transition away from coal energy. It was pointed out earlier, the closest coal plant to us is 70 miles away. They claim the plant will emit no smell. I submit to you, because emissions don't smell, doesn't mean they are non-toxic. The EPA claims from a study they did in 2014 that a 1,500 megawatt plant will emit 4 million 938,590 carbon dioxide a year. Can you dispute that? You want to dispute that? This is the largest contributor of climatic change. Is this really clean energy? Invenergy is not being truthful, dubious at best. They claim a reduction in our property taxes in the newspaper. Fallacy. I don't even think it's partially true. Our area is still recovering from big coal, which left scars on our landscape. Let's not add any more. We can do better. Council, please do the right thing and say no to Invenergy. Protect the safety, health, and well-being of our community. Thank you.
No problem. Thank you. Next witness.
Will Cynthia Sebastianelli please come to the podium?
Excellent job, Ron. Thank you so much for bringing us so far. Huh? Because it was driving me crazy. The pod doesn't go bad, John. You like to pretend it's not happening.
What's going on here and why it's important that we don't allow this variance to go through. And I'm a first generation here in Northeast Pennsylvania. I moved up here from Philadelphia. I married someone from Pentville, and we moved back here so that we could raise our child in a certain way, in a certain community. Someone mentioned earlier today the word integrity. And I think that that's really what's at stake here, what this whole proceeding is about. The integrity of this community. The reason why we moved here to raise our child. It's one thing to look at your daughter and try and explain to them what's right and what's wrong. But then have to explain to them, you know, we're a community that does things a certain way. Except or but if you have privilege or you have a certain amount of resources, or if you do things a certain way, there can be exceptions, there can be changes. And I think that really does sacrifice what is so special about Jessup and Peckville and the people of the valley, that there is an integrity, there is a communal sense of connection. That we're going to sacrifice if we allow these exceptions to be made. So that in a nutshell is my objection.
Thank you.
Sakulich, please approach.